Day number one of the Linux challenge. I'm doing this challenge basically switching completely to Linux on both my work and home PC. I go into exactly what it takes to switch all the way to Linux as your daily driver. Coming up. So there's a couple rules to this challenge I want to go over before I just jump right in and say, oh, I've switched to Linux, because many Linux guys that you see tout it saying, hey, Linux is the best thing ever since, you know, canned beer. Basically, they don't use the same amount of programs I use. I am an extreme power user. I do a lot of virtualization. I do many things in the legal community. I do litigation software. I do a ton of different program and software packages, and I am literally a Windows user, and I'm pretty much forced to use Windows, or at least I've always thought that. However, with Steam basically coming on and dominating the gaming scape just a couple months ago with Proton and getting all that compatibility, it made me think twice. Can I actually do it? I thought, you know what, let's give it a whirl. I went ahead and reformatted my work PC. It's a 3-monitor setup, and I put Fedora 29 on it. I went ahead and made my main boot Fedora 29 on my home PC. And this is what I will be using for the next 30 days. And anytime I boot back into Windows, I'm going to notate it down and tell you guys why I had to. But I'm going to first do Wine and try to use Wine to pull in that program. Many of my programs are definitely not on that compatibility list, and I'll go into exactly what steps I tried to get that working. I may even deviate and go into wine bottles a little bit, but I don't want to get too complex. I really wanted to make this video just to see if we can really, a hardcore Windows user like myself, switch to Linux. So it's day one, and I'm going ahead and pulling in some Windows programs. I'm going to make some Linux users or admins out there cringe, but I wanted to go ahead and show you guys, you can use Microsoft Office, you can use Photoshop, you just can't use the latest and greatest of these programs. So I'm going to go ahead and flip to my desktop real fast and show you guys what Word looks like. It's an interesting thing. I mean, this is Word 2010, so it's not great, but, you know, hey, it works. And then, you know, I have Outlook on here. I have a couple other things. And then I also have my Photoshop, which is not too bad. And I'm learning Gimp, but there is quite a big learning curve to Gimp. And I'm going to get into this a little bit, but I wanted to have, at least show you guys, hey, it's doable. You can pull up your Photoshop. You can pull up your Word. I have gotten some crashes, and some things don't work quite right, such as Photoshop export as. I actually have to save it as, you know, like a JPEG if I'm doing a thumbnail or whatever. So there are some things that don't work quite right when you do the Wine version of either Office or Photoshop, but I'll get into that as I'm going to be using these programs and kind of checking out the things. But I went ahead and went on Wine's site, looked at what was the most compatible version of these two programs that I'm very familiar with, and I have licenses for pretty much every single version of both. So I went ahead and just reverted back to Windows Office, you know, or Office 2010. And, you know, I was like, hey, yeah, it kind of gives me a little nostalgia because it's been a while since I've used it. But I'm also going to be switching. The end goal here is to switch off this and do completely all Linux. I'm going to tell you right now that by switching to Linux, the recording, doing the daily videos has really strung out that process. It's put a lot of strain on me because all these other tutorial videos I was knocking out. Man, in Windows, I was knocking it out in about 30 minutes for almost each video. And in Linux, I'm using Kdenlive. I'm using Gimp when I can, or at least try to use Gimp. And oh my God, I really just have to relearn all the stuff I already know and how frustrating that is. But I'm going to kind of do a mixture here. I'm going to stay on Linux, and that is the entire point here. And I'm going to slowly convert from Word to LibreOffice or Photoshop to GIMP. Outlook to Hiri. I've tried, I have Hiri on my work PC, and it works pretty good. And I'm trying all these things, and I'm going to see how far I can push the envelope to really switch to the Linux version, or if I just completely default back and go directly into my old roots and just launch in line Windows programs. I'm going to really try to really adopt these things. But in the first day, I have noticed I do lean on my Windows programs such as Word and Photoshop. However, I have used GIMP. I created a couple thumbnails. You'll see probably the next four or five videos I do. That's all going to be done in GIMP. However, there's not anything real complex with that. So a lot of the more complex graphic art, I'm still going to have to do Photoshop. As far as the video edits, I really like Kdenlive. The first couple videos I've tried it with, it went well. And I actually like it a lot better than what I was using in Windows. So That's really cool. Text editor, I do miss my Notepad++. I am not running Notepad++ in line. That is just silly. There's a billion text editors for Linux. I'm going to be using Atom for most of my programming if I'm doing any kind of coding or macroing, because I do quite a bit for a variety of other projects. I'll probably be sticking with Atom. And then for more text-based programs where I'm just doing a lot of copy replace, I'm going to be trying to use Kate. And those are going to be my Linux-based alternatives that I will be converting to. And I'm going to fill you guys in, but this is the first of like a not a daily vlog, but just a switch to Linux vlog to kind of see or show the average person what an extreme power user switching completely over to Linux, how it looks like, and what my experiences are.